As part of Climate Week, Air Miners has a big event coming up. We're putting together a panel with some of the luminaries of the Air Miners community. So these are people that are up-and-coming entrepreneurs, people that are really kind of the voices and the curious minds of the space. And so we're going to have a discussion with Jim Giles from Verge as a moderator. So he's great. He's got a journalism background, so he's going to come in and kind of, play the role of asking questions and asking these curious questions that sometimes we don't get to ask. So there's going to be five terrific people on the panel. Here's a link to the people that are going to be on the panel. Check it out. If you haven't followed the Air Miners event series, it's worth checking out. So we started the first Air Miners conference in May, and the idea was we wanted to do something virtual, but as we were planning it, COVID blew up, and so we really said, okay, let's see what we can do with this virtual online conference stuff. It was a huge hit, and since then, twice a month, we've hosted these Air Miners events, and our plan is to keep doing it till the end of 2020, or at least our plan is to keep doing it through the end of 2020 and beyond. But we have a schedule that's coming together, and so I want to tell you about some of the events that we've got planned coming up. We've got this Climate Week event on September 23rd. We're also helping with an event at the Verge Conference, the Verge Carbon Conference. I'm going to be moderating a panel on carbon moonshots, and we're going to hear lightning talks from a few startup companies in the space. If you want to check it out, sign up for Verge. Here's a coupon code that you can use to get a discount. Jim and the team provide that, so that's really cool. We've also got an event on environmental justice that's brewing, talking with Holly Jean Buck and Heidi Lim and some other folks. So we don't have a total announcement for that yet, but just kind of that's how it works, planning out events over the next couple weeks and months. As we've got some things in the works, there's some more that are really at the brewing stage, and so I'll tell you more about those as they come up. The Air Miners community has a wide range of interests, from tech to policy, direct air capture to soils. And so with the Air Miners event series, we want to have a wide range of topics. So what we've done is, so far we've touched on topics like direct air capture. We had a great event on life cycle analysis with Grant and the team from the University of Michigan Global CO2 Initiative. We also had a terrific event covering the 45Q policy, where companies can get tax credits for pulling carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. And we've got these other events coming up. And so we're really, covering a lot of different ground. And this is something this is here to stay. So we're going to continue to do this event series. We're going to keep doing these. At the time of COVID and with all this smoke in California, it's never been more important for people to be able to get together. And in this case, it's getting together online, getting together globally. The other thing, this is designed for the Air Miners community. We didn't set out to do events. Jason and Grant put out a community survey to ask people what they needed, what they were looking for help with, and just over and over, people connecting and getting to know each other came up. And events, in the age of COVID and at the California fires, events are a really good way to do that. But overall, normally I don't like events that much. I go to conferences. If I fly somewhere to go to a conference, I visit probably the first half day of the conference. I get worn out. I go back to my hotel room. I wander on the beach. Maybe I bump into people I know or I don't know. But that's kind of the conference experience. And on the other end, digitally, man, I cannot watch a webinar. I don't know what's up with my like attention, but like I just can't sit and input stuff into my brain so well. I think that's a theme with online events, right? It's like we want to connect to people, but it's not just a webinar. It's not just a pipe of information that's going into your brain. And so every step of the way, when we've been putting together these Air Miners events, we've been designing this with the community, for the community, and basically making it something that's helpful and useful so that people can get to know each other, people can make connections, people can find jobs or start new projects. Case in point, one of the most successful Air Miners events took like 5 minutes to plan. It was the Dynamic Networking of Air Miners, DNA. And basically what we did was we invited a whole bunch of people, and then we assigned people to breakout rooms. We said like, okay, you're there for 10 minutes. introduce yourself and talk. And that is, we got great reviews on all of our events, but the DNA event especially was one where people were like, hey, when are you going to do that again? Like, let's do that. And so again, that goes back to the idea of like, we're building these with the audience in mind. We're building these to be useful, to be helpful, whether they're simple or hard or easy or complicated. It's all for the, you know, in service of creating an experience that helps people who are working on pulling carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. My perspective as an entrepreneur is that this is one of the greatest levers that we have in order to speed up our ability to pull carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. Like I said, I'm not a huge fan of traditional events or conferences, especially not webinars. So it's not that I'm saying like we need to do that, you know, because it's, you know, something that I like doing. However, I think that at this time, our ability to pull carbon dioxide from the atmosphere highly depends on our ability to connect as innovators and entrepreneurs and scientists. When I first got into air miners, I saw incredible stuff happening, but it was all really siloed and people just didn't connect to each other. And so the Air Miners event series is really about bending the curve on pulling carbon from the air. And the bending the curve analogy, I'm not a huge fan of. Are we bending it up? Are we bending it down? Whatever. It's improving humanity's ability to pull carbon from the air. All that work compounds every day, every year, every decade. So the sooner that we start, the sooner we establish these connections, the sooner we accelerate what people are doing, the more that pays off over time. One other thing is we want to make these experiences really great. So we want to get that effect of amplifying our ability to pull carbon from the air. So it's like, okay, so how do we do that with an event? So when I first started thinking about this, and when I was working on it early with Jason and Grant, it seemed to me like, oh, well, we just want a lot of people. 200 people is better than 100 people, is better than 50 people. So it all came, you know, it was all about like attendees and stuff. But I started to think about some of the meetups and events that I've been to that were successful, that I felt really excited and empowered by. And it really wasn't about the number of attendees. If you think about a conference like TED or something, you know, I didn't meet a ton of people at TED because there's not a lot of people, but the people that were there, wow, like people that you're going to bump into, whoa, how do you create that kind of experience? It's not about the numbers of people. And also TED isn't great just because it's small, but it's about the interactions, and that's something that we track with Air Miners. Obviously, we keep track of attendees, but it's more, it's not an indicator, it's more of I forget what there's a name for a metric where it's not like the thing you're tracking, but it's kind of a side product. So sure, we get more attendees, that seems good. The metric that matters for Air Miners events is interactions. So it's people posting questions or comments. And we've had events where 30% of people that attend are posting a question or asking a comment. That is awesome. That's the stuff that I love. People start posting stuff 5 minutes in. Here's a question that I'm thinking about, or here's a comment, or you know, here's something I'm curious about what somebody just said. People start to build on each other. Somebody says this and that. That is totally the goal for Air Miners, is how do we make these connections happen better? Because the right connection can save you years. And if it's saving you years, it means it's saving years in the sense of being able to pull more carbon from the air. So we don't design the Air Miners events to be passively consumed, because I don't think that's what we need in order to figure out solutions to the changing climate. In order to build solutions to the changing climate, we need active participants. And it's not necessarily like fighting and arguing, but like being curious, asking questions, responding to stuff. And so that's why, you know, we really make the events very high engagement. People are asking questions. We throw everybody into one big Zoom room. I haven't seen many conferences like that. I see a lot of stuff where, you know, people do the webinar thing, which, like I said, is kind of this like one-way speakerphone kind of thing. But we throw everybody into a Zoom room. I think the software could be better. There's some warts and bumps in that, but overall, it gets us directionally in the right way. It feels more like an in-person kind of thing. And what's cool is it has the feeling of an in-person thing, but it has the advantages of digital, which means that people like Bill Gross, who's a famous innovator and inventor. One of his biggest projects is Idea Lab. He was able to just drop into an event once and start speaking and ask a question. And that's the type of interaction that's super duper powerful. It's not possible in webinars, and it's not possible in in-person events because you have to fly there. Same thing with getting Kim Stanley Robinson as a speaker, right? That was super freaking cool. And if we had had that event in person, I just, you know, we wouldn't have been able to do it. I mean, it just probably wouldn't have come to the event. So our goal is to pull together a wide range of people. We want to get people started. We want to provide tools and connections for scientists, entrepreneurs, and engineers who are working to pull carbon from the air. We want to get people that are building new tech. We want to get investors. It'd be cool to get somebody like Richard Branson or Sam Altman or Bill Gates, people that are like looking to make investments in carbon removal. Let's figure out how we can get them connected together. On the other hand, if you're new to all this, the Air Miners events are a great way to get started because we're going to be doing these twice a month. They're usually on Wednesdays, twice a month, Wednesdays through the end of the year. So if you just want to start picking up whatever the next topic is, whatever the next event is, by the end of the year, you can have met and heard different opinions from speakers, from participants, asked your own questions. So that's the Air Miners event series. It's built for the Air Miners community. Again, we didn't set out to create an event series. We set out to help the community get connected. We set out to go from people that you know of to create people that you actually know and you can work with. And we're starting to see some of that. We're seeing people get job opportunities or consulting opportunities or investments. We're also seeing a lot of people get connected together on a personal level, which is great. And the whole purpose of that is to help pull carbon from the atmosphere. It's to help connect innovators together. I mean, I think about like the CEOs of Climeworks, right? Like every time a company like that gets investment, it just gets a little bit harder to connect with them. It gets a little bit hard to know them and send them a joke or send them a dumb gif, whatever. And I just see that stuff as that's paying off in decades into the future. That's paying off when, you know, these companies are all going to be leaders in their field and leaders of this industry. And being able to just ping somebody or being able to remind somebody like, oh yeah, remember that dumb gif I sent you? It seems silly, but I think that's the network that will create that future that we need. We could leave this all organic, right? We could leave this to just happen on its own. I'm sure people would start meetup groups and conference groups and industry groups and all that sort of stuff. But we really, this has a deep purpose behind it, which is we want to figure out how to pull carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. We want to do it big. We want to do it fast. We want to do it high quality. We want to do it in a way that sets us up on this planet and for pulling molecules from gas on other planets. And so this is a core technology for that future. And the sooner that we can create it and create the systems that power it, the better. So that's where the Air Miners event series comes in. It's continuing through 2021, and I hope to see you at one of the next ones. Also, last week was the Climeworks Direct Air Capture Summit. I'd love to hear if you attended, what did you like, what could be improved. Huge applause to Climeworks for pulling together that event. That was something that was originally planned back before the age of COVID, and they did a really great job at like pivoting what they did, making it more digital, making it more online, and being something that people from all around the world can participate in and can check out. So what did you like about that Climeworks event?